Hello, my name is Luis Palacios, and in this lesson we are going to learn about the Django admin. The Django admin is without a doubt one of the most powerful parts of Django. And it's not that Django doesn't have many powerful parts, oh believe me it does, it has a great ORM with amazing capabilities. It can handle URLs using regex expression, which lets you do amazing things. The template engine has many helpful built-in features. It takes security seriously. It's written on Python, which is among the top popular languages. But when I got to know the admin, and I realized how much I could accomplish with so little effort, I immediately became a major fan for Django. Let me tell you a bit of the context in which I discovered the Django admin and why I'm so excited with it. I was working for a software development company, and all of the software we were building for our customer at the time had three major parts: a web application, a mobile application, and an admin site. The most important part for our customer were the web application and the mobile application, because those were going to be facing their customers. That is where we needed to set our focus and energy. They just needed the admin site for their staff in order to handle some basic configuration and manage some data normally stored on a database that will be served through a web API. While not as important, the admin site was still needed, and it will normally require much time and effort from our side that we wish we could invest into the customer-facing application. Not to mention the maintenance effort that will come after the initial development. When looking for a better approach, that is when I came across this. This is from the official Django docs website, and you can see the philosophy for the Django admin. It says that generating admin sites for your staff or clients to add, change, and delete content is tedious work, I know that, and doesn't require much creativity, oh yeah. For that reason, Django entirely automates creation of admin interface for models. That sounds really compelling, but could it be true? Well, we decided to give it a chance, and it is true. We normally took weeks or even months to create an admin site before. When we started using the Django admin, this became just a few hours or max a few days. Don't believe me? Stick around for a few minutes and you will see it for yourself. For this lesson, let's imagine a shrimp restaurant that needs to create a mobile application and a public website that will allow their customer to check their menu. That is their main goal, but they also need an admin website where their staff can log in and manage the menu that is presented to the customers. They will need to be able to handle menu categories, menu items, and menu tags. This is part of their menu, and you can see the menu category here, Starters, which has a name and an image. They will also have more categories which need to be ordered and set as active or inactive. Okay, time to build the admin site for them. Here I am on a new Django site, and I have already created the menu app and its ads here, as you can see. I already defined the models and also generate and run the migration, so it means we already have a database with the tables that I need. However, I still don't have a user interface for the staff users to handle the menu, so let's create one. On my terminal, with my virtual environment active, I will run the site on localhost port 8000. On my browser, if I go there, we can see the Django site running, and if I try to navigate to /admin, we can see the admin is already handling login for us, but we still don't have a user. We can create one from the terminal using the create superuser command. I just need to add the login and password, and now I should be able to access the admin. I will start the server again. Back at the login screen, I should be able to use the user that I have created. And here it is, the Django admin homepage. There is a lot that is already done for us. We can already handle users, permissions, login, logout. However, we still don't see anything related to our models in the menu app. That is because I haven't registered the models in the admin, so let me show you how to do that. Here on the admin file, the first thing I need to do is to import the model that I want to appear on the admin. I will start with menu category, and I will use the admin register decorator, and here I need to pass it the model. I will start with an empty Python class that inherits from the model admin class, so we can see what I get by default. I will save my changes and back into the browser. If I refresh the page, you can see that there is a link for the menu categories. And here I can see the menu categories list page, which right now is empty. And from here I can add a new category. I will add the starters category as the number one, and I will select the image here, and you can see that by default is active. When I click save, the new category is added and I'm redirected back to the categories list page. That is impressive considering the amount of code I have written. However, there is still a couple of things I need to improve. First, the list is displaying this weird menu category object 1. Instead, I wanted to show it the category fields such as the name, the order, and so on. Also, we can notice the admin is trying his best to pluralize the name of my model, however, it's not doing it right. I will put the models and the admin side by side in order to make things easier to follow. I will start by specifying the plural name I want for my menu category model here on the meta class. And now I will specify the fields I want to appear on the list page by setting the list display field on the admin class. Here I need to pass the fields from the model that I have registered. Now if I refresh the page, the plural name is fixed. And if I navigate to the list page, I can see it's displaying the fields that I wanted. For the image, it's using a link, and if I click on it, I can see the image. But what if I want the image to appear directly on the list? That is easy to accomplish, because I will need to write HTML code. I will need to import the format HTML function from Django Utils. And I will need to create a method on my admin class, and I will give it the name of image.tat, and it will receive an instance of the model that is being rendered. And here I can write the exact output that I want. On my case, I want to use an image tag and give it the src of the image URL on my model instance. I will also set a short description for my method. This is what the admin will use for the header label. And on the list display, I will use my method instead of the image field. I will format the code and save, and let's go back into the browser. If I refresh again, I can see the image is now being rendered. I will add another category, and one thing I didn't show you initially is that we already have validation in place. Quite impressive considering we didn't do anything for it. I will add the drinks category as the number 3 now. I will click save and back into the list page. And here in the success message, it's using this menu category object. In order to fix that, I will go back to my models and I will set the dunderstart method for my model to return the name of the field. If I add another category now, I can see the success message now uses the name of the category. I will add another category now, but this one will not be active. Back into the list page, there is more things I need to address. First, the order in which their categories are being displayed is the order in which I have created them, but I want them to be ordered by the order field on the model. I also want to have a filter for the active and inactive category, and last, a search functionality. In order to do that, I simply need to set 3 more fields on my admin class. In the ordering field, I set a list of the fields names in which I want my list to be ordered. If I add more than one, it will become a then by order. On the list filter, I set the fields for filtering, and I do the same for the search fields. If I refresh the page now, I can see that my list is being ordered by my order field. Also, I can see this filter panel that will allow me to filter by active categories and inactive. I also have this input that will allow me to search by category name. Again, pretty amazing considering the amount of code I have written. I even got this action dropdown that will allow me to apply bulk actions to the selected categories. Now, let's imagine the users wants to update the orders of the categories without having to go into the detail view, because it's easier to update the ordering when seeing the rest of the categories. So how can we do that with the Django admin? You can probably guess by now. We just need to set another field in our class, this time the list editable. The only condition for the fields on the list editable is that they must also exist on the list display. If I refresh the page now, you can see that the order is now editable on the list page, and I have the save button down here. So take a moment to appreciate how much we have accomplished with just a few lines of code and in around 5 minutes. I hope you can understand why I love the Django admin so much. I hope by now you have seen how quickly we can create an admin site using Django. It is not only quick, it is also very easy to use. And on this lesson, we learned how to register your models, about the basic configuration, and even how to customize the output for each field. And now that this is out of the way, you can set your focus on what's really important.